Houston to get started. You're in for a treat as we bring you NBA basketball on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan. We'll be hearing from David Aldridge on the sideline. Take a look at the Hawks. Well, they know they have their work cut out for them here tonight and during a stretch of games facing a lot of talented teams. Let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. Grant is out there with Portis. Then there's Valentine. Then there's Markkanen. And it's Felicio in at the five down low. Now about halfway through the season, Grant, some teams looking great, but we still have a long way to go. We're talking about an 82-game schedule that is meant to put teams and players really to a full test.
Yeah, it's really something. I oftentimes find myself, Kevin, looking back after 14 years of playing at a team's schedule for an upcoming season, and I scratch my head and I go, wow, I used to do that? I mean, that's not easy to do.
It's very difficult. I agree. Nice pass, nice catch, and a resounding dunk.
Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. Love to see him get up like that.
Bazemore passes to Devin. There's the screen. Out to the right wing. Schroeder against Grant. That one good for two. Schroeder's got his first points of the game.
And Schroeder did not even have to think twice about that shot. This young man simply devours these chances inside.
Pass to Portis. This one for three. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
There's a chance he could go for a big game if they don't beat him up on the
rim. Against the Pelicans. Stolen away. Oh, and a pass break for the Bulls. Grant leading the charge. And the powerful one-handed slam.
And this is what happens when you fail to block out.
Defensive rebounding just as important as causing the miss in the first place.
Now here's Schroeder. He's coming off a 22-point game against New Orleans.
He also did a masterful job in that game of drawing a lot of fouls, so he's creating havoc for the defense.
And Kevin, who says a point guard should look to pass first? I mean, not when you can finish like this guy.
Well, he wasn't going to give that opportunity up to a teammate.
And that's what we're seeing more and more. Point guards who can finish as well as they make the play.
That one goes in.
And Markkanen continuing to improve inside. I mean, utilizing his height, D has a tough time matching up with somebody with his skill set.
Here's Schroeder from outside off the mark.
Not a problem when that's your first miss of the game. Strong start.
Down low and stolen by Bazemore. By himself, and a slam dunk by Bazemore.
Well, that's some speed right there shown by Bazemore. The bucket is as easy as they come if you run like that.
And the replay is courtesy of Under Armour. Unleash chaos. It was a great sequence from the steal all the way to the finish at the other end. For the Hawks, you go back to the summer of 2016. How big was it for them losing their all-star, Al Horford?
Well, the rumor is there wasn't too much of a financial difference between what the Hawks were offering and what the Celtics ended up giving Al Horford, and they wanted to have him back and maybe trade Paul Millsap for assets. That all did not happen, and it gutted the team a little bit because of Horford's versatility. You could see that reflected in some of the offensive numbers from the Hawks last year.
And Grant drops them both. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Schroeder gets to Collins. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. It's blocked.
And how about Markkanen using his size and reach on defense? Great timing in terms of being able to get up and block shots.
Now, here's Valentine. Currently averaging almost 6 points a game.
Well, he's like a fumbling banker right now, dropping dimes with ease. I like how well he led his teammate on that possession.
Bazemore dishes to Devin. There's a good screen to the left side wing. Schroeder gets good from inside. Schroeder's got 7 points in the game. Here's Grant. Now let's send it over to David Aldridge, who was able to talk with Mike Budenholzer.
Well, Kevin, they have a specific approach to tonight's game. He told me they have to get the ball into the paint as much as possible and take advantage of what they believe is a big edge for them inside. We'll see if they're ready for that tonight.
Thank you, David. Chicago shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. And the first one. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Robin Lopez is checked in for Felicia. Bonley comes in for Markkanen. David Mwaba is checked in for Portis. And Kristen subbed in for Jared Grant.
Coach Budenholzer comes from a basketball family. His father coached for over 20 years. Feels like he was just born into it. Definitely what many would consider a coaching lifer.
Taylor kicks to Delaney. Back to Taylor. Passes it to Delaney. Just five on the clock. There's Noah Bonley with the front. That's his first foul. And Mike Budenholzer, winning coach of the year in the league in 2015, leading the Hawks to 60 wins.
Well, that was the most wins in franchise history. An amazing collective effort from the Atlanta Hawks that year. No doubt, a high watermark that he's hoping to surpass in the next couple of seasons and become elite in the Eastern Conference.
And here are the Bulls now, following the three by Atlanta. 139 left in the first. Here's Dunn. He kicked it by Taylor. Now the pass to Delaney. And as it goes out of bounds, Atlanta able to keep the ball here. Just a moment to look back at how things were last season for this team as we look at the shot breakdown for the Hawks.
And their offense centered around a three-point shot. That was the guiding principle on every trip. Their first goal was finding an open look beyond the arc, getting that extra point every chance they could.
1:16 left to play here in the first. Lopez passing to Valentine. And he banks in the layup. We've seen the lead change hands quite a bit in this one.
And guys, I think each team knows they can win this game. Just no matter who can catch that momentum.
Atlanta with the ball. They trail by one. Here's Taylor. And the rebound goes to Lopez. For Chicago, they've gone 6-9, shooting it well. To the middle. It's tipped. Lee outside. Makes it off the glass.
These teams going back and forth all night.
Yeah, which team's going to find some consistency first? Neither one can pull away.
Lopez. And Lopez throws it down.
Man, it's just been an avalanche of points here in the early going.
Yeah, for both teams, we're seeing great synergy on offense, but some lackluster defense.
Atlanta with the ball. Back to Taylor. 3 second difference between shot clock and game. Here's Valentine. Over Lee. And so, lots of scoring in that competitive first quarter. It's Chicago up one. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. Of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And taking a look at Chicago's performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
Well, to me, the story of that first period was their rebounding.
Yeah, jumping out to a lead largely because they did the hard work on the glass. So you love the passion and the very clear this game that they're playing.
Chicago leading. In a moment now, reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the court right now for the Hawks, he got Lee, and it's Dorsey in at the two guard.
Even with the defender in his face, Bonley makes the adjustment there necessary to get off a decent look.
and Dorsey kicks to Delaney. Deadman passes to Delaney. His shot is good, making a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
Artful passing on that play, showing the real desire to set up the teammate.
Now, here's Dunn. T right on him. That's a no-go, and he's still looking for his first bucket after two shots. Now Dorsey in the corner. It's Delaney. Lee kicks to Deadman. Screen by Lee. Shot off the pick. Rebound by the Bulls. Moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
Yeah, and some of that loss was due to a lack of hustle, especially on the defensive end.
And there are games where an opponent gets aggressive, you got to raise your level of play. They failed to do that in this one.
The dish to Deadman. Hawks passing it around. Three-pointer. Tries again. A shot that time, not on target. Good D by Lopez. Dunn dishes to Bonlow. Here's Lopez. And that basket is going to count. Goaltending, the official call. Brett, when you were playing, best assist year statistically of your career, what led you to become such a catalyst for that offense?
Well, it was interesting just as I finally got an opportunity to start to play with the basketball as a two-guard a little bit more in Seattle, trying to play a little bit more up-tempo. And again, I'll mention opportunities because of Gary Payton getting double-teamed. It opened up situations for you, Kevin, where I could be a bit more creative as the offense. I wish I had more years of doing that, kind of the run-and-gun style that Phoenix employed for most of the mid-2000s with that 7 seconds or less. I could have been agreeable with that.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Felicio's checked in for Lopez. Markkanen comes in for Bond. And it's Grant in for Chris Dunn. Shot clock at 6. There's the screen. Baseball for 3. Atlanta again missing. Chicago leading by 3. Grant with the ball. To the inside. Markkanen with the basket on the assist by Grant. Grant's got 4 assists now tonight.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Here's Dorsey. Outside Bruce. Puts it up from 12. Jump shot is good.
And trust me, Dennis Schroeder would love to score the basketball, but his ability to set up his teammates is also a fact.
Grant kicks to Portis. Back to Grant. Now, here's Markkanen. Guarded by Prince. Here's Felicio. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And you gotta like the vision for Markkanen. I mean, a big man who knows how to find the open man.
Guys that are looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
And Dorsey gets to Collins. Pass to Prince. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Coaching staff high-fiving themselves there, watching that team move the ball around, doing whatever is best for the team.
Grant the pass to Markkanen. Screen by Grant. Markkanen kicks to Mwaba. Oh, good with the triple.
Close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that tonight.
Here's Bazemore, looking at his point production. He averages almost 11 points a game. Prince misses.
And getting a hand in the shooter's face, locking down that in-between area.
Just taking on the challenge on every possession. I love defenders who give nothing away.
Alicio, no good. The Hawks trail by 3. Taylor's checked in. A 1:50 left in the second quarter. Kicks it to Schroeder. Lets it go from deep. And once again off the mark by Atlanta. The Bulls leading by 3. There's the pick. Markkanen kicks to Mwaba. They get it back. Atlanta's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Prince. Here's Collins. Nice work on the board.
Great positioning on the glass, jumping all over that miss and sticking it back in.
And the first time out of the game called for Chicago. Their last encounter was in Chicago.
And simply put, they couldn't score. They never got completely in sync in that one.
This is when you look at the opposition and give them some credit with their defensive effort, just a higher level of energy and focus. They were disruptive.
Passing two guards in basketball. You take a look at Bazemore, top five in the NBA, and his teammates love him.
And that list of players just goes to show that great passing doesn't just come from the point. The way those guys distribute the ball from the two spot is a thing of beauty.
Yeah, it truly is. You need to have scoring from that off-guard position, but with the way the point guards score nowadays, a ball mover is certainly an asset. And the way those guys spread the ball around, that's what you get.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
They set the pick to the inside. Dwaba gets the bucket. Dwaba's got his first points of the night.
He has a little bit of trickeration with that one. Gets that one to go against the lift.
Wait, did you just say trickeration, TA? I think it's a size disadvantage there that he was willing to attack, but you have to develop that skill set and have counters.
That evens the score. Bazemore's got five.
And that's just a pretty looking stroke from the outside by Bazemore there. The perimeter shot now a staple of his game.
Grant dishes to Markkanen. Pass to Portis. Five on the clock. They set the screen. And the shot falls short this time. Here's Taylor. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. And the Hawks lead by two.
A terrific use of the floater. Unguardable, really, because you can't do anything defensively to stop it.
Here's Prince. By Mitchell, would have kind of had it gone in. And the first half comes to a close. We've got a close game going on here. Hawks lead by two. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
We so hope you enjoyed our first half. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. This is the Halftime Report. A competitive matchup for Atlanta in the first quarter. Some good action during the period, as it was just a one-point game at the end of one. They battled hard in the second quarter, and it was reflected on the scoreboard. Kenny, what was your take on Atlanta?
Well, their reserves showed up tonight, not just on hustle plays, but in points. And that's what you got to do coming off the bench to maximize your minutes.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Chicago?
Aggressive. I called them up earlier. I like it. They're taking it hard to the rack, dictating the pace, setting the physical tone. You're not going to get that by launching threes all night. Everybody knows that.
And we're just about ready for the start of the third quarter. Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll see you.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half is about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. The Bulls shooting at 50% in a decent group. Tipping off the second half, here's Fred Hoiberg's five. They got Grant. Valentine out there with Markkanen. And it's Portis in at the two guard. Here's Portis. Back to Grant. Six to shoot. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Grant's got the game tied up here for Chicago.
they didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
On deep, Prince is rebounded by Portis. And here on there's a pass now. And following this one, actually on the Hornets in New Orleans. And that's a falls in the middle game of this three-game trip. Prince kicks it over to Schroeder. No good from outside. And Dennis Schroeder out of Germany handed the keys as the full-time starter at the point guard in his fourth season.
And with his confidence and competitive spirit, you know he was chomping at the bit for that opportunity. And you got to love his athleticism coupled with that big play capability. It's just exciting to see how good this young man can become.
And Chicago has possession after the miss from Dennis Schroeder. Markkanen kicks to Valentine. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And a moment here to check out the stats. Three rebounds and two assists. And guys, no question, he's a guy with some talent. But honestly, even he'd like to see those numbers improve.
From all the whispers that we've heard, he's been working hard on his game. It just has not showed up yet in the box score.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Lopez is checked in for Felicio. Noah Vonleh comes in for Markkanen. And Chris Dunn subs in for Grant. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. And we've seen coaches that yell. You've seen some that show no emotion. And everything in between. Markkanen hits the perfect mental makeup for an NBA coach.
I don't think, Kevin, there's any exact science to what coaching can be. And I think the best coaches just have an innate ability to know when to push buttons, how to push buttons, and to do it on an individual level. There are many times that a coach can make the biggest impact with his player, Kevin, taking him aside and having conversations rather than doing everything in front of the team. And I think the best coaches have a pulse of each player on their team and take the time to go and do that.
The Hawks have gone 2 for 3 at the foul line in this game.
And as a team, really just middle of the pack in terms of their percentage from the line at about 76.
And the Hawks making a change here. Dorsey's checked in. Now, here's Dunn. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. And here's Vonleh. And it's going to be a 3-second call. This pause in the action gives us a chance to see the teams that have scored the most points off turnovers this month. Number one, the Bulls.
They're taking advantage of every mistake that their opponents are making. I mean, they're really converting points off those turnovers.
Out of bounds, Atlanta takes possession. And we've got a moment now to check out the Eastern Conference standings and see where everyone is sitting as things begin to settle down just a bit through the midway point of the season. Taking a look at Chicago, earning the first place position with a terrific record. And we've seen them perform splendidly pretty much all season long so far, and they got them in the team to beat. And checking out Atlanta, just way behind.
And for Chicago, they had plenty of doubters before the season started, and I can't imagine there's anybody out there that's taking them lightly anymore.
Well, how could you? They're a team that's actually feared at this point, and that is legit. They go into every single game, no matter who's the opponent, and they expect to win.
Outside. Now, here's Dunn. He's covered closely. And it's good for two. Dunn's got it all tied up now for Chicago.
There's just no way you are stopping Dunn when he's that close to the bucket. A skilled finisher and an amazing athlete.
Delaney, no good.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game.
Here's Portis. 5 points in the game. Here's Vonleh. And it's Chicago scoring again. Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Delaney, the pass to Devin. Valentine grabs the board. The Atlanta Hawks come into this one following a loss to New Orleans.
I mean, frustrating when missed free throws become contagious. Really, the Achilles heel in that.
Yeah, you try to put up these scoring runs, and it hurts when you all of a sudden just give away free points from the free throw line.
And Kalentine gets it to go on the assist from Lopez. And now a four-point Bulls lead. Hawks have gone just 25% from the field here in the second half, the 2 of 8. And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks.
Yeah, it's a good time to talk things over, trying to stop what's been a brutal run.
Yeah, he's got to use every device at his disposal at this point, and I think he wants to give other guys a breather right now.
Have gone, averaging about 7 points, 3 assists, and 4 rebounds. And guys, no question, he's a guy with some talent, but honestly, even he'd like to see those numbers improve.
From all the whispers that we've heard, he's been working hard on his game. It just has not showed up yet in the box score.
Now, here's Valentine. He's got 8. 1:24 left to play in the third. Lopez dishes to Valentine. That one, no good. And it's the Hawks taking it the other way. And now, here's Lee. A fast break opportunity. Atlanta again, missing. Chicago leading by 4. Here's Lopez. And so he draws the foul on the shot. Trip to the line to shoot 2.
All the officials are all over that.
Bulls shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here. Again. Bridgewater is checked in for Atlanta. And he sinks the 2nd. 1:02 left to play in the 3rd.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Back to Tatum. Pass to Delaney. Collins kicks to Delaney. To stop the drought, and once again off the mark by Atlanta. They can go 2 for 1.
It's about being smart right now.
Lopez passes to Bonley. It's his first trip to the line.
Numbers this year at the line below 70, so when he's getting to the line, really as effective as he does.
A 5-star recruit coming out of high school. Vonleh was the 9th overall pick in that highly anticipated draft class of 2012.
Princeton's champion for Atlanta. Dennis Schroeder comes in for Malcolm Delaney. Now, here's Taylor. He averages a bit over 6 points a game. Collins dishes to Schroeder. Up off the spot.
Even though Schroeder might be on the light end of things when it comes to his weight, he remains relentless driving towards the basket.
Time. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2. And there's the foul. This goes against Atlanta. Bulls have shot 8 of 10 from the line. That's an even 80% free throw shooting here.
And it's been an average year, really, at the free throw line for this group. Only around 75%.
He hits both from the stripe.
And Dunn does a little bit of everything out there. Scores the ball, distributes it well, and also comes the glass aggressively.
Schroeder. And the shot is good, driving in off the front of the rim. Schroeder's got 4 this quarter.
And just enough wiggle room to get off to a shot.
Tremendous focus with the bigger guy all over him. It speaks to the toughness he has down there.
And we've reached the end of the 3rd. Bulls out front. They lead by 4. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the 4th quarter. Head coach Mike Budenholzer is mic'd up along the sideline. Let's check it out.
Be more committed in the paint. Don't block the shot. Go get a board. Get more active in the paint. Give us some more.
Budenholzer trying to ramp up the aggressiveness in all phases of the game for his team.
Well, I think he senses that his guys are kind of holding back a little, that they aren't really getting everything out of each possession, and they need to start now.
And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter, and if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. Grant's out there with Collins. Then there's Dennis Schroeder. Then there's Kent Bazemore. And it's Taylor in at the shooting guard. So that's the lineup for a minute.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high percentage looks from inside.
Grant kicks to Felicio. Back to Grant. To the middle. And Markkanen throws it down.
And how about the hops there by Markkanen? He knows not many guys can block that shot. Good at getting that deep post position.
Now, here's Taylor. Here's the screen. Nobody near Schroeder. Again, the hop score.
A nice screen. Really a poor defensive reaction and the obvious result.
Yeah, when you fail to get over the top, more than likely that jumper is going to go down.
Here's Markkanen. Misses the three.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Here's Bazemore. And that one goes long. Chicago's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Valentine passes to Markkanen. Here's Grant, and the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Bucket earned, out-muscling and out-hustling everybody for the rebound.
To the left side wing. And Grant sends it back. Here's Markkanen. It's deflected.
Yeah, this is a terrible start for him, and it has to be weighing on him.
And the dunk by Bazemore.
I love how Bazemore just takes it to the defense on the drive and finishes that one easily. Shows no mercy when the ball's in his hand.
Now, here's Grant. Grant with the defensive effort.
Yeah, tonight his shot's been a bit off, but still, they lead the game.
To tie it up. Yes, that goes in. Bazemore's got the game tied up here for the Hawks.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Now, here's Grant. There's a screen. Markkanen sets the pick for Grant. Goes to the right wing, launches it, tips it up, controls the rebound, and puts it back up and in. And the Bulls lead by two.
Oh, and a nice job of turning that miss into 2 points on the tip-in.
Hustle points, I believe they call them. Hustle points right there. Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over.
Yeah, it's an opportunity to kind of regroup and discuss ways to maximize these possessions.
And therein lies the trick, discussing ways to be aggressive but not committing turnovers.
Jordan, player of the game.
And the way he's made his mark with his work inside, he's always moving, getting to the basket at will, and just seemingly taking advantage of a D that was reluctant to get in his way.
Here's what Atlanta's going with right now. Wayne Deadman's checked in for two. And it's Malcolm Delaney in for Dennis Schroeder. The Bulls making a change here as well. Portis has checked in. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Thanks, Kevin. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team during the break. He told them that they're getting it done in the paint. He said they can't guard us inside, guys. Keep taking it to them. Pound it down low.
The offensive rebound. And it will go, and the Bulls lead is cut down to just 2 points on the bucket from Collins.
Yeah, nothing too fancy. Just getting the job done when they need to make every possession count. Just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Jones, he did not look into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that back one.
.151 left in the fourth quarter. And in kicks to Valentine. Down low. And to break that ice cold streak, misses at the rim.
And you just get the sense the whole period he's been a bit out of sync.
Sometimes you just can't figure out what's wrong, but he keeps trying to push through.
Now, here's Valentine. Makes it off the glass. And the Bulls lead by four.
You cannot give players that kind of positioning, and the defense also late in trying to alter that shot.
Here's the break. Here's Grant. Nice pass. Run into the rack perfectly for the layup. Grant's got six in the quarter.
And that's what you want in transition, a high percentage opportunity.
The story is true, and here the defense does a very poor job of matching up.
Bruce Bazemore, after Jerry Grant's bucket. Oh, that's him. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a high 71%, 5-for-7. Time called here in the Bulls. They're in front by four. 106 left in the fourth quarter. 106 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Portis, the pass to Felicio. Stripped away. That's his first foul. The pass to Delaney. The feed now to Prince. A three off the mark. Here's Portis. 35 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. He feeds it to Markkanen. Shot clock at five. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. Felicio kicks to Markkanen. Running down the shot clock. Markkanen's got the lead up to six now for Chicago. Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. They're trailing by six. There's 21 seconds left to play here in the fourth. From deep, Prince. Another miss by Prince.
That's just poor shooting right now from him, and I'm not sure why he's even attempting those kind of shots.
16 seconds left in the fourth quarter, and he commits the intentional foul. So the first one's out, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And so both free throws are good. That's an 8-point game. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Tipped away. On to Taylor. 3-pointer. Trifecta! It's up a three. So the Bulls win it. They seem to relish their role as the bad guy here tonight.
You know, Kevin, I sense that as well. I mean, they really did feed off all of that negative energy this crowd was directing at them. I mean,